Slavin with the WDBE Weekly News. Today is Monday, October 24th, 2016.
Good morning. I'm Emma Petrie. It's the 48th day of school, and there's only 127 till the end of the year.
I want to welcome you to our first broadcast of the year. We hope the show is informative and entertaining.
Now let's send you over to Aiden and Max for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Good morning. I'm Aiden Hines.
Good morning. I'm Max Deegers. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Now over to the weather desk for this week's weather.
Thanks, Aiden and Matt. Now for this week's weather forecast. Keep in mind, we are not meteorologists yet.
This week looks like to have a high in the high 60s and low in the mid 40s, with a range of partly cloudy and sunny skies all week.
It looks like outside recess will be a go all week, but some days you may need a light jacket or sweatshirt.
Now over to Duncan and Marin for our Cafe Nutrient News.
Hello, I am Duncan Hall. This week's breakfast menu will be Tuesday, apple cinnamon toast or toast and cereal with chocolate chip muffin or mini pancakes at Grab and Go. Wednesday's breakfast pizza or yogurt and cereal with mini donuts at Grab and Go. Thursday, sausage biscuit and gravy or biscuit and cereal with berry muffin or breakfast bun or yogurt and frozen grams at Grab and Go. Friday, glazed donut or toast and cereal, yogurt, and Trix bar, or mini Cinnies at Grab and Go. Now over to Marin.
Alright, thanks, Duncan. You've just made me really hungry, and I just ate breakfast. On to the lunch menu for this week. Monday will be, and line one will be chicken nuggets with fries in a roll. Line two will be mac and cheese with roll, baked beans, and a fresh veggie bib. Grab and Go will be Tostitos and salsa. Tuesday, in line one, will be barbecue on bun with potato stars. Line two will be pizza choice, fresh veggie boat, and buttered corn. And grab a go will be a turkey stick. Wednesday, in line one, will be a bologna and cheese sandwich with chips. Line two will be Salisbury steak with mashed potatoes and gravy, green beans, and a fresh veggie boat. And grab a go will be a baked potato bun. On Thursday, in line one, we have cheese pizza. In line two, we have spaghetti with meat sauce, breadstick, garden salad, steamed broccoli, and grab a go pretzel and yogurt. And on Friday, line one, we have chicken noodle soup with grilled cheese. And on line two, we have a cheeseburger with lettuce, tomato, pickles, and fries. And then a fresh veggie wrap. The grab-a-go will be a ham and cheese wrap. Duncan, what kind of food do math teachers eat?
I don't know.
Square meals. Well, let's send it to Logan and Isabel for some school news.
Hi, I'm Logan Johnston, and we're here to tell you about special events happening here at Daniel. It's not too late to turn in a pumpkin for the pumpkin fun contest in the library. But tomorrow is the last day. Remember, no carved pumpkins. Pumpkins should be turned into a character out of your favorite book. These are a couple of examples. The Rainbow Fish and Captain Underpants. All students will be voting on their favorites Wednesday, Friday this week in the library or another related arts class.
Hi, I'm Isabel Grant. This coming Friday, October 28th, 5:30 to 7:30 p.m., Daniel Boone will be hosting the third annual Fall Costume Ball. There's no cost, but we would love canned foods for the Backpack Club. Items include canned ravioli, canned chicken noodle soup, boxed granola bars, boxed fruit chews, please no blood or horror costumes. Costumes should be elementary appropriate. Awards will be given out to the best family, best boy, and best girl. So come out and dance and have fun at the fall ball.
Now, back to the news desk with Ethan and Emma.
Emma, have you seen all the pumpkins in the library? I think I might have to go home and make one tonight.
I'm going to go home and get my costume together for the fall ball. Up next are Jaden and Samuel with a couple of book talks for some great books that you might find in the Library Media Center.
Hi, I'm Jaden Tommy. I'm going to tell you about the book Snowman All Year. What would you do with your snowman if he never had to melt away? That's what one little boy wonders. They could go on so many adventures. They could fly a kite together in the sweet spring breeze, watch fireworks shooting across the hot summer sky, or dress up to go trick-or-treating on a chilly autumn evening. This story's imaginative narrator can't help but imagine what he would do with his frosty friend if the fun never ended. With beautiful illustrations and a great overview of the seasons, this one book you'll pull out season after season.
Hi, I'm Sammy Randall, and I'm doing a book talk about Elijah Buxton. Elijah was a special person in Buxton for a lot of reasons. First of all, he was the first free baby born in the settlement. The settlement of Buxton was in Canada and was started by a minister who didn't believe in slavery and bought a piece of land so the slaves escaping from the U.S. would have a place to go where they could be safe and free. Elijah was the first baby born there who had never been a slave. Second reason he was special is because he threw up all over Frederick Douglass. Douglass was a black statesman and former slave and was making a speech about Elijah while he was holding him up over his head, bouncing him around and saying he was a beacon of hope and light. Elijah opened his mouth and started throwing up all over him. It was a sight no one in Buxton would ever forget. Another reason Elijah was special was the way he fished. He didn't use a pole or line. He used rocks and half-dead horse flies. When he dropped those flies in the water and they started buzzing around on the surface trying to take off, a big old bass or perch went crazy trying to catch them. Then Elijah would throw rocks at them, knocking them out so they'd float to the surface where he could just scoop them up. He could throw hard and fast and hardly ever miss. So in just one afternoon, he could catch a dozen fish, enough for two or three folks other than his family. And he had enough to trade for a fresh baked pie as well. But the biggest reason Elijah was special was because of what he did when someone stole the money that Mr. Leroy was saving to buy his wife and children out of slavery and bring them to Buxton. He went south into the United States to get the money back. Elijah had never been in a country where human beings could be owned, bought, and sold. A country where even if he told his people that he was born free from Canada, he was still in danger of being captured and enslaved himself. Elijah was special because he knew the right thing to do, and he did it in spite of how dangerous it was. Now back to Over and Emma and Ethan.
We have one more segment of the news for you today.
What's that, Ethan?
This day of history.
Hi, I'm Zoe Fair. On this day in 1901, 93-year-old school teacher Annie Taylor became the first person to take the plunge over Niagara Falls in a barrel. You can read more about her adventure in the book Barreling Over Niagara Falls by Macy Kelly Allen. This book can be found in the biography section of the library.
Thanks for watching our first episode.